circle right now, a circle that Sting has tried to invade blatantly tonight, destroying the limousine, and later on tonight, Sting and Bret Hart, U.S. title match. It's going to be more than a match. It's going to be an explosion here tonight on WCW Monday Nitro. Fans, will let you know that next Monday, Nitro originates from the United Center in Chicago. That's Monday, October 12th. Tickets, box office, and Ticketmaster in Chicago. Monday, November 2nd, we're going to have Nitro, the brand-new National Car Rental Center in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Tickets at the Center Box Office and Ticketmaster. In 3 days, we're going to be in Indianapolis with Thunder Thursday, October 8th. Indianapolis at the Market Square Arena for Thunder. Tickets available at the box office at Ticketmaster. Also remind you, this Wednesday, October 7th, in 2 days, we're going to be at the Von Braun Civic Center for a big WCW card in Huntsville, Alabama. Tickets available at the Von Braun Civic Center box office in all Ticket Link locations. And this Sunday, this weekend, it's a big weekend for WCW in Milwaukee. This Sunday, October 12th, at the Milwaukee Arena. Tickets available at the box office in all Ticketmaster locations. Still to come, information about WCW coming to the Shenandoah Valley of Virginia and Roanoke, in Topeka, Kansas, in Wichita, and in Fort Wayne, Indiana, during the course of this program. So you fans in those areas, stay with us with your pen, your papers ready for some ticket information.
I tell you, you can leave the SIS off this guy's name and just leave it as Psycho, because he is weathering one of the most careless of all the luchadors. This guy will take risks that are not favorable if you're looking for return dividends.
Psychosis gets a chance tonight to become WCW Cruiserweight Champ, a title that's been held by many great stars, one of them right now, Kidman. And Kidman gets a well-deserved standing ovation here from the fans. The young man deserves it all, because not only is Kidman a very hard, determined young man, but he broke away from the flock, became his own man, and look what happened because of it.
Hey, he's got some gold. He saw the light, and that light took him all the way to the shower.
And you notice he's not scratching anymore, itching himself. He's away from the flock. He's a new man. He's clean.
One of the other great cruiserweights we'd like to say hello to is Rey Mysterio Jr. Rey on hand in San Diego last night when the Padres wrapped up the divisional series. We'll now go on to play the Atlanta Braves, and we'd like to say hello to all of our great Major League Baseball players who watch our program each and every week, including our good friend Brian Boehringer of the Padres, who'll be going to NLCS.
What a pitcher, Brian Humdinger.
It's Boehringer that is. And hello to all of
who?
Please,
Jangles.
Stop. And hello to all of our great fans, wherever you are. And I know everyone's glued to the set tonight. Sting and Bret Hart. And I just wonder what condition these men are going to be in when they got to wrestle a little bit later on.
Well, Sting looked like he was ready to fight to me. He had Bret Hart for about a minute or so, but I don't think anything happened to Bret Hart except he's just going to light the fuse in Hart. Hart's a fighter. It's going to be brutal.
You know, not only that, going to be a great match. I want to see what's going to happen here. Don't forget the NWO Black, Red and Black. They're out looking for Scott Hall and that big limousine, and Mike Tenay's tailing them. Something's going to happen.
I believe you're right, and that they will not be stopped. It's like Big Sexy said. What a night. You know, it's really, if you think about Sting and his plans for revenge, we've never seen Sting like this. He's always been very mysterious, very methodical, very calculating. Cover one, two. But to see Sting do something like this, you know, to see someone destroy a limousine is obviously apart from the norm, but to see Sting be the man to initiate it is really incredible.
Well, when that limousine pulled up and they all got out of the car, and I'm talking about Luger and K-Dog and Sting, they had something on their mind.
Oh!
They just didn't take a ride to the building. They got out of that limo, and they had something on their mind. Sting was looking for Bret Hart.
You know, Bobby's right. They were men on a mission. They had the eyes of a hunter, and they found the prey.
Kidman trying to fight off the advances here of Psychosis, and a great guillotine leg drop from the apron into the ring, and almost a three count. Charles Robinson, the referee, lets Kidman know it was only two. Kidman thought maybe he had it with that maneuver. One thing that has led to Kidman's stardom here, not only becoming a champion, but also the phenomenal moves that he executes.
Well, too soon!
He ducked his head low. Psychosis, a luchador, I might add, picks up.
Oh!
And a
reverse suplex or an old Anderson Gord Buster, if you will, that time.
He's wasting too much time. You want to become cruiserweight champion, you better go for the pin.
Cover, hook the leg, and he almost got him again.
Yeah, too late. I mean, the airplane doesn't leave till the morning.
And Kidman, face first in the center ring, in trouble here.
I think he could have had him had he gone for the cover right away.
Fans also, we understand in a few moments, have a very special one-on-one interview with the Warrior. That's going to be interesting to see what he has to say about Hollywood Hogan. A top rope flying body attack that time. It hit Kidman in the back of the head. He may have the belt here. One, two.
No.
Hey, two and a half. It was close, but Kidman squirmed out in the nick of time.
Well, you're not going to win any gold talking to the referee. You better get on Kidman if you want it, Psychosis.
You're not going to make any sense talking to a referee either.
No, you're right about that, Larry.
Boy, man, give the referees a break here, guys.
You've never been in there with them.
No, of course I haven't, but I know the ones we have work pretty darn hard.
You know, you're right. We should give them a break. Around the neck.
In the mouth. I am glasses.
You want to add on to this, Brain, before we go any further?
C&I dog, white cane, whatever you like.
Sleeper type or crossface maneuver that time. Here comes Kidman. He ducks low. Whoa. Kidman with a great drop kick.
Nice and high. Got Psychosis right in the mouth.
Kidman again. Undaunted. Sends him in. Psychosis firmly holds his ground center of the ring, but Kidman kicks him. Here comes Kidman.
There goes Kidman.
Yeah, not kidding, Larry. All the way outside. Beeled him out using his own momentum that time, and I think maybe hit the small of his back against that hard apron of the ring that time.
Now, look at this. This is reckless. You hurt yourself doing stuff like that. These guys are nuts.
That's what the Cruiserweight division is all about, with or without the Disco Inferno, depending on what weight class he's in. Come on!